In this video, I'm going to cover some examples of incremental analysis to help answer the question of should the product be sold or processed further. So first, let's look at a single product example. Pine Street Inc. makes unfinished bookcases that it sells for $62. Production costs are $36 variable and $10 fixed. Because it has unused capacity, Pine Street is considering finishing the bookcases and selling them for $70. Variable finishing costs are expected to be $6 per unit with no increase in fixed costs. So now we need to prepare a per unit analysis to decide whether they should sell the bookcases unfinished or go ahead and finish them by processing them further. So back in the paragraph, it tells us that the sales price per unit is $62 and the production costs are $36 variable and $10 fixed. And so when we put that in our table, we can see that the net income per unit is $16. If Pine Street decides to finish the bookcases, the problem tells us that they could sell those for $70, so our sales price per unit goes up to $70. However, it also tells us that variable finishing costs are expected to be $6 per unit. So if we take the initial $36 in variable costs, add on those finishing costs, the new total variable cost is $42 per unit. The problem tells us that fixed costs do not change, and so we can see that if they choose to process the bookcases further, net income would be $18. And so now if we fill in our net income column, we can see that if our sales increases from $62 to $70, that's an $8 increase on net income. Our variable costs would have a $6 increase, which causes a negative impact on net income, but overall we would have a $2 increase in net income if Pine Street chooses to process the bookcases further. And so, since it's a positive number, we would choose to process further. Next, let's look at a joint products example. Chin Minerals processes materials extracted from mines. The most common raw material that it processes results in two joint products, D and E. So they take a raw material and it creates two products. Both of these products could be sold as is or could be further processed and sold at a higher price. The company incurs joint costs of $180,000 to process one batch of the raw material to produce the two joint products. So now we need to do an analysis of whether each product should be sold at the split-off point when it's first made or processed further and sold for the higher price. So when we go back to the problem tells us that joint costs of $180,000 are needed to create products D and E, the initial products. Those joint costs are not a relevant cost in our analysis. They have to do those processing costs or else they don't have any products. They just still have their raw material. So we do not include joint costs in our decision to sell or process further when we have multiple products. So now let's look specifically at product D. If we sell product D as is, the table tells us that the number of units they sold will be 4,000 and the price at split off is $10, so the revenue they would receive is $40,000. If they choose to process it further, the selling price becomes $15, which means they would receive $60,000. Which means a total net income would increase by $20,000 because revenues would go up from $40,000 to $60,000. However, when we factor in our cost to process it further, which is $14,000, we can see that that will cause net income to decrease by $14,000. However, overall, when we look at the totals, if they choose to process further, net income would increase by $6,000, which means they should go ahead and choose to process product D further. Now let's look at the analysis for product E. So product E has 6,000 units that at the split-off point could sell for $11.60. So if they choose to sell product E as is, they would make $69,600 in revenues. If they choose to process it further, their new selling price becomes $16.20, which means that their new total revenue would be $97,200. Overall, that would cause a $27,600 increase to net income. However, again, we have to factor in those additional processing costs, which for product E are $28,000. And so if they choose to process further, they have those additional costs, which makes net income decrease. And now we can see that overall, if they choose to process it further, the additional revenue they get does not exceed the additional cost to process further, and it would actually have a negative $400 impact on net income. So for product E, they should choose to not process it further. Okay, and so now we've gone through three different types of analysis looking at our sell or process further. For our single product, our joint product where we said yes, they should process it further, and our joint product where we said no, they should not process it further.